Dave, my other question for you is how people can find their values or what's their purpose in life? Because we are always asking this question, know your why are you doing the things, know your values that will help you, that will guide you. So how can people find those values? And is it important to have an alignment with the companies that people are applying to align those values with the company's values?
I'm going to go back to the first question and offer a few more tips and then answer the second one. I think there's other tips around disappointment. I think, and I'm going to give three or four. One is rejoice in rejection. If you're disappointed, it means you cared. And I think, in fact, kind of consistent with your second question, if I'm not disappointed, I didn't care. I didn't have that as a value. So when something doesn't work, I should be rejoicing that I've begun to learn my values. Another tip for managing that is when things don't go well, manage my expectations. Sometimes we see ourselves differently than we'd like to become. And sometimes in a job search, we think we're able to do job A, B, and C, when in fact we can do C, D, and E. And getting my expectations as clear as I can. For example, in my life, I've struggled for most of my adult life with weight and trying to say, oh, I'm going to weigh 170 or 180. Lately, I've begun to say, that's just not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. Mm-hmm. And so to begin to manage some of those expectations and say, this works for me. And even in relationships, not every relationship is going to meet every need. And so managing those expectations. And the other tip for when I'm disappointed is find ways to focus on what's working more than what's not. So as human beings, we often want everything to be perfect, and it's not. If we focus on what's right and what's good, hopefully then we can begin to move forward. So I was preparing for this interview, there's a great song out of the 1800s by a songwriter, happened to be a Christian songwriter, called Count Your Many Blessings. And my father used to make me sing this, you know, count your many blessings, name them one by one. And Dad had disappointments in his life, as do we all. And he kept saying, so Dave, that's sad. What's gone well today? So those are some ways to think about the disappointments that come from job search or life or the realities of life.
Yeah, I agree with you. And I feel that with the social media presence, we feel that we're always seeing these people having more stuff than we have, and we're becoming losing what we have. We always want more, and we're not happy what we have. Or we're seeing these people that are doing very well, and then we get disappointment, or we doubt ourselves that we are not doing enough to be successful like those people.
I love that comment, because I think we compare ourselves with others. And in social media, everybody who posts on Instagram or Snapchat or Facebook, you know, they're at a beach with palm trees and beautiful blue skies. Well, I'm sitting home today with snowy and icy roads, and I'm not dressed that well. And I think we need to be comfortable with who we are, which is not easy to do. And Mahara gets to your second question, values. You know, and I don't think we have a perfect match with our values and our daily activities. That's naive. But what is it that excites me? What are my passions? What are my strengths? When I say, if I had a free day, what would I like to do?
Mm-hmm.
And those, I think, help us get more clear. I like to read. I like to think. I like to write. What do you like to do, Meher? What are the things that, if you had free time, you would love to do?
I'd like to do more painting and more reading books. I'm trying to find some more time, but I'll be more happy to do those things if I have more time.
Well, and then I begin to say, what's behind that? What's behind reading and books? And it's, I sense, for me at least, and I love those things as well, I love to learn. And books is a vehicle to do that. And so I say, you know, I may not have time to read a book today, but I can learn today. So how do I begin to recognize my strengths, my passions, my interests, my values, if you will? And they're not going to happen every day. I mean, that's naive. That doesn't happen. But But if I can see the underlying values and goals, I can maybe find small things every day that help me do that better. And so at the end of my day, as I pause and reflect, for me, some of that is through meditation. Some of it mm-hmm. is through prayer with the divine.
Yes.
What did I do today to experience my values? What did I learn? For me, it's also learning, but it's also serving. Mm-hmm. Who did I serve today? Did somebody cross my path that I could help today? And some days the answer is no. And I go, oh man, I need to be more sensitive tomorrow.
Yes.
But I think those are the kind of things that help me at least feel like I'm trying to live my values.
Yeah. And how can, if we know our values, how can job seekers see that alignment with the companies that are applying, knowing that the unemployment rate is down and from recruiter point of view, from my colleagues, people are saying that if we post one job, we're getting 150 people applying. So how can one person applying those jobs get the attention of the recruiter and shine when they're applying? And how is that value alignment important?
You know, and so the challenge becomes, A, is this a company I really want to work with? I'm betting of many of those 150 applicants are almost doing a programmed application. They're just sending off resumes.
Mm-hmm.
I want to really think, is this in fact the job that I'd like to go for? It's not just a numbers game. And then through social media, Glassdoor.com, social media, learn about the company. And so when I send in a resume, take the extra 15 minutes and tailor it. This is why I like your company. Don't just send a generic resume. You'll get a generic response.
Yes.
And then when there is an interview, show your knowledge. I'm trying to do some work at this company because I know you've had a CEO for 2 months, and I know that she's bringing in this set of orientation, and it's something that just really fascinates me, and I think I could bring skills that might be helpful to what you're trying to do. So I think showing that extra effort may separate you from the 30 or 40 people who are serious.
Yeah.
Of the 150 applicants, 120 aren't serious. They're just throwing out generic resumes.
Yeah.
And you're not competing with them. But okay, really try to separate yourself from other people.
Thank you very much for those tips, Dave. That's very valuable. And I feel, and I hope my audience are taking those notes that Dave is giving, because tailoring your resume is important, knowing your values is important, and being grateful what you have is very important. And if you have any other tips or anything that you are doing is working, please share it with us. And if you have any questions, again, we are more than happy to answer it for you.